principle. There's no honesty.
The idea that Jeremy Corbyn is not putting forward a vision for Brexit is to completely ignore everything that's not the job of a leader of the opposition.
The job of the leader of the opposition is to contradict everything the government is saying on principle and to put forward the contrary. He's not doing that. He's sitting there waiting.
The leadership of the opposition is to provide a vision that reflects the principles of its membership. And that could viably unite the party.
But no one knows what their principles are on Brexit.
One of the reasons why, the reason we don't know what their principles are on Brexit is because we're constantly talking about, for example, a few weeks ago, we were spending days and days on end talking about a book that was released on Jeremy Corbyn that accused him of lying about shaving his beard when he was in Jamaica. Do you remember when we
We want to talk about Brexit, not Jeremy Corbyn's beard.
Jeremy Corbyn has had the same vision for Brexit, which is to remain in the customs union, to remain in the single market, and to protect workers' rights and environmental protections in a way that ensures that those protections are maintained.
He voted against joining the European Union in 1975. He still seems to be against being in the EU.
Jeremy Corbyn, like a lot of people in Britain, has a critique of the EU. But what he is proposing is a kind of soft Brexit that enables us to still participate in the majority of the EU's activities, but whilst also still retaining the ability to make some decisions outside of the EU as well, particularly when it comes to workers' rights and environmental protections. That's the vision he laid out. That's a vision that I think can actually...
But you're explaining it a lot more clearly than he does. Quite frankly,
this is what I am getting from just watching, from actually investigating and seeing for myself. Because what we're seeing,
why doesn't
he
say it then?
So
why does he leave it to you to say it rather than standing up and saying it in the House of Commons?
The reason is Jeremy Corbyn, John McDonnell, Diane Abbott, all of these people articulate this. But the problem is we're so focused on demonising Jeremy Corbyn and people who voted for Jeremy Corbyn as an individual, that we're not even hearing the things that he's saying incredibly clearly over and over again.